is hefty.
Hey everyone, I'm Steph. Chris is behind the camera and we're hungry to travel. We are in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, a multicultural country with an incredible culinary scene. The food here is so diverse and varied with the different flavors and cooking techniques of the Chinese, Malay, and Indian populations. And today we are going to take you on a street food tour of epic proportions throughout all the deliciousness this city has to offer. So come on, let's go. We're heading now to try a dish called chilli pan mee, which was invented here in Chow Kit. We're here at restaurant Kinkin to try their chilli pan mee. So this is a dry noodle dish, and what really makes it is the chilies here. Oh, these look pretty spicy, so I'm gonna start low and slow, you know? Look at this, we've got dried pork, the noodles, we've got these chilies now, a nice fresh egg, as well as anchovies, green onions. This is just packed, so here we go. Wow, look at that egg.
Wow.
Oh my gosh. So you can see the noodles are dry, but having this egg cracked in there. That is some spicy sambal. Wow. With the pork and the anchovies, give it a little bit of saltiness to it as well. And with the egg, it's kind of nice and creamy and rich, but that chili is not to be messed with. That is spicy. That really builds up the heat. I love dry noodles like this. Just so rich and tasty. Mmm. The noodles themselves are cooked kind of al dente, so they're not really, really soft and mushy. They've got a little bit of chewiness to them. The chilli pan mee also comes with a nice soup here, like a leafy egg broth. A little bit salty, nice flavor with those leaves. Mmm, this is tasty, nice soup. We had to cut the spiciness and the heat with a nice little tea tart. That's good. That's perfect. You can really taste the freshness of the noodles since they're making them practically fresh to order right here in the shop. Perfect. Look at all the ground pork and everything that's left at the bottom there. So packed. So nice to get to try this from where it originated. We're just entering now into the Chow Kit market here in KL, which is Malaysia's largest wet market. Thank you.
This wet market is huge. They sell everything from fruit and veggies to your meat, anything you kind of want that's kind of like wet and raw. And they also have like kind of like a dry market on the side as well. So this place is so huge.
So many unique fruits and vegetables here, even some we've never seen before. This is definitely the place to come to get groceries or anything you need here in KL. Hello.
Saw this giant jackfruit and thought we just had to taste some. So we're gonna get a little pack here.
Good one.
This one looks pretty good. Look at those big pieces there. Wow.
Nice.
Is it heavy?
Yeah, 17 kilos.
17 kilos?
Oh wow.
Whew. That is hefty. Wow, look at this. That is a heavy jackfruit. 17 kilos, wow. All right, so we just had to try a piece as well, and the lovely owners here gave me a nice glove to eat it with so I don't get my fingers dirty. Look at the big pieces of this jackfruit. Mmm, so tasty, so fresh, nice and perfectly ripe. It's kind of like creamy actually when you bite into it, not too sweet and with the seed in there, but so refreshing this morning. Wow. Has a bit of a strong smell when you kind of walk by and they're cutting the jackfruit, but the taste actually, it's not strong at all. It's pretty mild. Mild and sweet. It's delicious.
So good, so tasty. Oh, thank you. Oh, honey. Terimakase.
Oh, so they have a different type here. It's a honey flavored jackfruit. Yeah, you can tell it's a bit more yellow than the orange jackfruit that we bought here. Wow, it's much sweeter actually. It's a lot milder tasting. Almost kind of tastes sweet like honey.
Oh, very, very tasty. Terimakase.
Oh, this is delicious. It comes with so many, so we're gonna put this away and we'll have a nice little snack for later. It's awesome.
Terimakase.
We had to stop at this drink cart to get ourselves a milk tea. Look at that. This is definitely needed on a hot day like today. Oh, so refreshing. The milk teas here in Malaysia are unreal. They're so smooth and rich and creamy with the condensed milk in there, but still such a strong tea flavor. And the gentleman here, he said that he wanted to show us how he makes his iced coffee as well. So we're gonna be in for another show. So good.
Thanks.
Oh, wow. So tasty and refreshing.
Oh, it smells so good.
Yes. You want to try some?
Sure.
The owner here at Bak Coffee is amazing, such amazing hospitality. He wanted us to try his signature iced coffee here in his coffee truck and made us one. It's so nice and frothy, look at the color of that. With the condensed milk in there. Oh wow, it's got a nice coffee flavor, but with the condensed milk, nice and sweet as well, but you can still taste that really strong coffee. Oh, hey ho, Yama. Oh, it's really tasty. Wow. Such a special coffee, and to see him kind of pull and kind of watch him make the coffee just like the tea tarak as well. So, so cool and amazing. That's really like creamy and almost kind of like chocolatey and rich. Almost like velvety as well. Wow. This is an amazing tasting coffee.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Have a nice day.
Such good drinks.
Thank you.
Super tasty. We're gonna go bring these to our next meal.
We are here to try Hokkien Mee, which is a stir-fried egg noodle from the Fujian province of China. So it's a Chinese Malaysian dish. Look at the color on that. It's from the black soy sauce. And now this is a fried braised egg noodle. Look at that. It is just covered in soy sauce and fried up using wok hai, which is the breath of the wok. So the really, really hot wok is what gives it interesting flavor. Look how chubby these noodles are. Those noodles, so chewy, cooked to perfection. And the soy sauce is so rich, so dark. That's so good.
Delicious.
Posek. It's packed with ingredients. We've got cabbage, some sotong, the squid, pieces of pork, fish cake, as well as a little pieces of fried pork fat, the sort of lard there. Pork's really good. It's
It's lovely as well. Nice texture. And everything goes well with the cabbage too. It gives it a nice little veggie crunch to it. The black soy sauce gives it such a nice rich flavor. And the wok hai just gives it that little bit of extra something as well. And Hokkien mee can be found all over Malaysia, but the Hokkien char mee, the dry noodles like this, is a KL specialty. So we are lucky to get to try this while we are here because I love dry noodles. And these chubby guys are awesome.
We're heading off now a little bit out of the way to the Jalan Bellamy area to try some traditional and special Malaysian dishes. Hello.
Super hot outside today, but nice and cool in this Grab taxi we got.
This one, chuchu udang.
Chuchu udang.
Chuchu udang. Calling this one. Tahu.
Ah, tofu.
Tahu.
Tofu. Ah, yes.
Cucumber, sengguang. With egg.
Oh, an egg.
Egg.
Okay.
This one, sotong.
Ah, sotong. Squid.
Squid.
Yes.
Gravy.
Ah,
this
okay.
One, peanut.
Peanut sauce.
Okay.
Oh wow!
You had, you know this.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
That's sotong squid.
Okay.
Okay. This looks delicious.
Delicious.
Thank you so much.
Terimakasih.
We're here at Rojak Bellamy to try the famous rojak, which is a traditional Malaysian dish. So it consists of, I think, fruit and veggies, and he put some noodles and squid on top, along with some peanut sauce. Really interesting dish with the fruit and the veggie mix. Interested to see what it tastes like. Mmm. That was a piece of tofu. The sauce is quite sweet, actually, but nice and nutty because it's the peanut sauce. But not spicy at all. Really nice flavors. And the crunch of the cucumbers that are in there too. Wow, really interesting dish. He also put a hard boiled egg in there as well and cut it up. So, egg with peanut sauce. There's no better combo than eggs and peanuts. Both of my favorites. It's like a spaghetti, it's like a peanut spaghetti. And there's the piece of the squid there that he put in. Nice thin slice of squid. That's nice squid. It has that chewy texture that squid kind of does, but because it's sliced so thin, it really goes well with the noodles. The peanut sauce just makes everything taste so peanutty, but so delicious at the same time. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. See you next time. Thank you. Wow, so nice of them. Wow, such good hospitality here in Malaysia. Amazing.
Hold on. Here at Hunky Chicken Rice, they cook it fresh to order, and it takes about 25 to 30 minutes to cook each clay pot rice because they cook the rice from scratch. So, oh wow, done. Oh, thank you very much. Wow, so our 25 to 30 minutes is up. Let's go eat. We are here to try the clay pot chicken rice, and this looks absolutely amazing. So there's chicken in the hot clay pot along with Chinese pork sausage and green onions, it looks like. And there's also a little bowl with salted fish in there, so I'm just gonna dump that in. So I see other people, they're supposed to spoon it up and put it on a plate, but since, you know, we have one, we're just gonna eat out of this clay pot. Wow, look at that. Look at the big pieces of chicken there. Look at the soy sauce rice. Lots of Chinese sausage there as well. Oh, let's give it a mix.
It's packed.
Packed with meat, rice. Smells so flavorful. I feel like I want to eat it with this big spoon here, but we'll be civilized and use a smaller spoon. Oh, the smell of the rice is amazing. Mmm. Wow, so flavorful right away. You get the taste of the chicken. You can taste ginger in there as well. But the rice is cooked perfectly. Not too soft. Has a bit of a kind of like a chewiness to it as well. Almost like al dente, actually. Mmm. And with the Chinese sausage, so flavorful. The Chinese sausage has a bit of sweetness to it as well, so it's kind of almost like a pork jerky kind of flavor to it, but goes amazing with the salty rice and the green onions there. Mmm. This is delicious. These big pieces of chicken here. So tender with the white meat there, and again I can really taste the soy sauce and kind of ginger sauce that's on there, so really powerful and strong flavors, but so tasty. Mmm, piping hot. It's super cool how it's cooked too on the coals outside of the shop here, and how they put the coals on top as well to help cook it evenly. It actually gives the rice a little bit of like a smoky flavor as well that I can taste. But, and here we have the salted fish that came with it as well. Mmm, oh, that is salty fish. Que hoseca, really good. Delicious rice. You know it's cooked right when you got a crispy rice bottom from the charcoal fire in the clay pot here. Oh wow, look at that rice. Mmm. Crispy, crunchy, amazing.
We hope you've enjoyed our Malaysian street food tour here in Kuala Lumpur. If you have, give the video a like. Let us know in the comments down below which food was your favorite, and make sure you subscribe to our channel to come on our next food adventure with us. We're hungry to travel, and we'll see you next meal.